Good afternoon,
miss.
Okay. Type present in your chat box. Type present in your chat box.
Good afternoon, miss.
Good afternoon. Please turn on your video.
Good afternoon, ma'am.
Good afternoon. Please type present in your chat box.
Good afternoon, ma'am.
Okay, shall we start?
Yes.
In the morning session, we have discussed the, let's revise. Page number 12, isn't it? Am I audible? Can you hear me?
Yes, miss.
Yes, miss.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now we are moving to our next page, that is page number 14. Let's revise. Okay. Shall we start?
Yes.
First question. Why did the author leap out of his bed? Why did the author leap out of his bed?
I see water pouring on his face.
Yes.
The ice was falling on his face so that it is not safe for him. So he leaves his bed.
Yes, very good. Because he felt icy water pouring down on his face. So the author leap out of his bed. Is it clear?
Yes.
Yep.
Then the next question. What was the first thing that the author tried to save from the pouring water? What was
his typewriter?
Yes. His typewriter. Very good. His typewriter. Then third one. Which section of the roof had not been damaged by the storm yet?
Children's room.
Children's rooms.
Yes, very good. The section of roof where the children lived with their parents. Children's room. Fourth one. Where was Toby?
In their kitchen.
Yes. Toby had taken shelter in kitchen. Is it clear?
Yes.
Okay. Then we are moving to the next one. Page number 15. Let's revise. We noticed that the water on the floor was beginning to subside a little. Where did the water go?
To the second floor.
Where?
The second floor.
Yes, second floor. We can say that water went to the floor, to the rooms below where their neighbors lived. Below the rooms. Okay. Is it clear?
Yes.
Then the next question, what reminded the author of a painting by Salvador Dali? What reminded the author of a painting by Salvador Dali?
This snow looks like.
Remind.
Which one?
A clock covered with the snow.
The snow covered.
Yes, the clock on the wall that had stopped and was covered with the snow. It seems to be like an art done by Salvador Dali. Then, third one, why did the author's family not consider moving into another house?
There was no other
houses.
Yes, because it is impossible to find a vacuum house in Missouri, isn't it? There was not availability of houses. There was no houses are available in Missouri. Is it clear?
Yes.
Okay. I will give you the answer later. Okay. Now we want to move comprehension. Page number 16. Comprehension. Page number 16. First one, A. Write true or false. Write true or false. First one, the author lived in a three-story building. The author lived in a three-story building. True or false?
True.
Yes, true. You can write there true. The author lived in a three-story building. It's right. So you can write the true. Okay, then the next one. Dolly was scared of the field rat. True or false?
True.
Yes, true. You can write true. Okay, next one. The children's mother was at her best in an emergency. True or false?
False.
False. What was the real answer? Correct answer?
Prem.
Yes. The children's father, Prem. Isn't it? Then, next one. The snow reminded the author of a painting by Picasso. True or false?
False.
False.
Yes, false. The snow reminded the author of a painting by who?
Salvador Dali.
Yes, Salvador Dali. Then, last one. Prem went out to find a carpenter and a tinsmith. True or false?
True.
Yes,
true.
Yes, it is true.
True.
Prem went out to find a carpenter and a tinsmith. True. Then, next one. Answer these. Which one?
First, second, third one.
Yes. First one, true. The author lived in a three-story building. True. Second one, Dolly was scared of the field rat. True. Then the children's mother was at her best in an emergency. False. Then the fourth one, the snow reminded the author of a painting by Picasso. False. Last one, Prem went out to find a carpenter and a tinsmith. True. Please mute your audio. Okay. Now we are moving to the next one. Answer these questions. Answer these questions. Which line in the story suggests that the building in which the author lived was strong? which line in the story?
I live.
The old building in which I live for yes. over 100 years burned, the brunt of the wind and the rain as they sweep across the hills from the east.
Yes. You can write up to major damage. We had lived in the building for over 10 years without any untoward happening. It had even taken the shock of an earthquake without sustaining any major damage. Did you see that? You can see it in page number 12. It is in page number 12. Second paragraph. I live has for over 100 years received the brunt of the wind and the rain as they sweep across the fields from east. We had lived in the building for over 10 years without any untoward happening. It had even taken the shock of an earthquake without sustaining any major damage. Is it clear?
Yes.
Okay, then. Next one. Whom did the author live with? Whom did the author live with?
With three children and their parents.
Yes,
with you can see. Adopted children and parents.
Adopted children, not adopted children, adopted family. Page number 12. I live on the top of the floor with my adopted family, three children and their parents. The author lived with his adopted family, three children and their parents. Page number 12. You can see it in page number 12. Did you see? Shani?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes, miss.
Okay, then next question. How did the author keep his books? How did the author keep his books?
Shelves.
What kind of shelf?
Door locked
shelf. Yes, open shelf. The author kept his books in an open shelf. The author kept his books in open shelves. Hence, they were exposed to people who borrowed them easily. They were also exposed to the rain and the sleet. Is it clear? The author kept his books in open shelves. Hence, they were exposed to people who borrowed them easily. They were also exposed to the rain and the sleet. What is? Okay, then next one is, how did the children help the author? How did the children help the author?
The children help the author to
take the author's book
and manuscripts.
Yes, very good. Okay, the children helped the author by saving his books that were kept in the open shelves. They picked up armful of books and carried them to their room and piled them on the beds. Their room was relatively dry even though the floor was wet. They also helped to take some manuscripts also. Then the next question. Why did the house become a safer place after the lights went out? Why did the house become a safer place after the lights went out?
Because of the snow.
Because?
The rain was over or the snowfall.
Please read the question once again. Why did the house become a safer place after the lights went out? Lights went out.
താഴെയൊക്കെ വെള്ളം ഉണ്ടായിരുന്നു അപ്പോൾ കറണ്ട് പോയപ്പോൾ സേഫ് ആയി.
Yes. There is some broken electric wires, isn't it? So there is chance of sparks. Okay, I will read. Water splashed along a damaged electric wire and caused sparks. This was a dangerous situation since the floors of the house were wet. It could have caused electrocution. Hence, the author says that the house was a safer place with no electricity. Light full of fire and then current boy po. Our life is a risk. And then danger coronu. അതുകൊണ്ട് നമുക്ക് പറയാൻ പറ്റും അവരുടെ ഹൗസ് ഒരു സേഫർ പ്ലേസ് ആയി ആഫ്റ്റർ ലൈറ്റ്സ് വെന്റ് ഔട്ട്. ഇസ് ഇറ്റ് ക്ലിയർ? ഞാൻ ആൻസേഴ്സ് എല്ലാം തരും, ആൻസേഴ്സ് തരും, അത് നോട്ടിലേക്ക് എഴുതി വെച്ചാൽ മതി. ദെൻ നെക്സ്റ്റ് വൺ, തിങ്ക് ആൻഡ് ആൻസർ. ഓക്കെ, ഡിഡ് യു ഗോട്ട് ഓൾ ദി ആൻസേഴ്സ്? ആൻസർ ദീസ് ക്വസ്റ്റ്യൻസ് അപ് ടു 5. Yes. Okay. Then.
Yes.
Next one. Think and answer. We are often helpless against nature's fury. Be it a storm, an earthquake, or a flood. Do you agree? Justify your answer with the examples from the story. We are often helpless against nature's fury. Fury means anger. During the time of nature's anger, we become helpless, isn't it? Yes.
Yes.
Be it a storm, an earthquake, or a flood. Do you agree? Justify your answer with examples from the story. Do you agree with this? Yes or no?
Yes.
Yes. What is the reason for that?
Because we can't stop wind and rain, etc.
Yes, we can't stop them because it's quite natural, isn't it? Okay, here in this chapter we can see how the author and his adopted family survived that heavy storm, isn't it? Yes, it was very difficult for them to survive because their roofs were blew off and then the rooms were filled with water and there is also the falling of snow, isn't it? We can say that this is a natural disaster. We can't prevent natural disaster, isn't it? So you can write like this. Then next one is vocabulary. The phrase snow crystals glinted like diamonds is a simile. Have you heard about simile?
Not yet.
No. Figaro speech. We had discussed about Figaro speech in the last class. I think from the poem.
Olympic Granny.
Yes, Olympic Granny. What was that Figaro speech?
Kavigal avarude kavitha
അതിന് നമ്മൾ എന്തായിരുന്നു പറയുന്നത്? റെപ്പിറ്റേഷൻ ഓഫ് ഇനിഷ്യൽ കോൺസണന്റ് സൗണ്ട്സ് നമ്മൾ പ്രത്യേക ഒരു പേര് പറയും.
യെസ്,
അലിട്രേഷൻ. സിമിലി ഈസ് അനദർ ടൈപ്പ് ഓഫ് ഫിഗറോ സ്പീച്ച്. ദർ ആർ മെനി ടൈപ്സ് ഓഫ് ഫിഗറോ സ്പീച്ച്. സിമിലി ഈസ് അനദർ ടൈപ്പ് ഓഫ് ഫിഗറോ സ്പീച്ച്. You have studied about alliteration. Alliteration is one among figure of speech. Figure of speech കുറേ ടൈപ്പ് ഉണ്ട്. അതിൽ ഒന്നായിരുന്നു അലിട്രേഷൻ. അത് കഴിഞ്ഞ പോയതിൽ നിങ്ങൾ പഠിച്ചു. Now you are going to study about simile. Simile, metaphor, personification. അങ്ങനെ കുറേ തരത്തിലുള്ള figure of speech ഉണ്ട്. Poet used figure of speech in order to beautify the poem. Okay? I have already said that. Isn't it?
Yes.
Now we are going to study about simile. Simile. A simile makes a comparison between two unrelated things that have a common feature by using the words like or as. Simile ennu parnal endanu direct comparison aanu. It's a type of direct comparison between two different objects. Rendu different aayittulla object ne endu cheyunu compare cheyunu. Using the words like or as, directly compares two different things using like or as. Like allengil as idundavu simile. Simile kandathan vendite eluppana figure of speech simile kandupidikkan vendi namukku eluppana. You should remember that in simile we can see like, the word like or as. For example, he is like a lion. Ramu is like a lion. Here Ramu is a person, isn't it? Lion, yes. Lion is another one, isn't it? Here Ramu is compared to that lion. Is it clear? Like a lion, poleyanu. Ramu oru lioninne poleyanu. Appo avade edanu like, direct comparison. We are doing direct comparison to different objects, two different objects, and we are doing what? Direct comparison using like or as. Is it clear?
Yes.
Yes. You can see some examples here. ഈ example വായിച്ചു കഴിയുമ്പോൾ നിങ്ങൾക്ക് മനസ്സിലാവും, ക്ലിയർ ആയിട്ട് കൂടുതൽ മനസ്സിലാവും. The clouds were like cotton wool. Here the clouds are compared to cotton wool. You can see the word like or as. Which one?
Like.
Yes, like. The clouds were like cotton wool. Here the poet compares, here the line compares clouds to a cotton wool. Clouds enganeyana? Clouds cotton wool ine pole aanu ennaanu parayunnathu. Pole aanu. You should know that like or as. Then Major Anuj Sood was as brave as a lion. As brave as a lion. Oru lioninne pole brave aanu aaru? Major Anuj Sood. Here you can see the word as, isn't it? Here Major,
yes. Anuj,
here Major Anuj Sood is compared to a lion. He is as brave as a lion. The next one is, the night was as dark as coal. The night was as dark as coal. here the night is, the darkness of the night is compared to cold. Then you want to fill the blanks with the suitable words from the box. Then you will get more examples for similes. First one, you can see the snow, beehive, ocean, statue, glass. First one, the river was as clear as. What will be there?
Glass.
Yes.
Ocean.
Page number 16. The river was as clear as glass. You can write there glass. Did you write justice? Okay. Okay. Then next one. Sabha froze like a dash at the sight of the spider.
Statue.
Yes. Sabha froze like a statue at the sight of the spider. You can write spider. Sorry, statue. You can write statue. Okay. Then the next one, third one. My grandmother's hair is as white as dash.
Snow.
Snow.
Yes, snow. Snow. Very good. My grandmother's hair is as white as snow. Then the fourth one, the market was buzzing like a
beehive.
Yes, beehive. The market was buzzing like a beehive. Last one, fifth one. Parents' love for their children is as deep as the
ocean.
Yes.
Ocean.
Ocean. I think now you got an idea about simile. Yes. Because these are examples of simile. What is a simile? We directly compares two different objects using like or as. Is it clear? We directly compares two different objects using the words like or as. Is it clear? Okay. Now, let's move to the next activity. Okay, once more I will read all the answers. First one, the river was as clear as glass. Then second one, Sabha froze like a statue at the sight of the spider. Then third one, my grandmother's hair is as white as snow. Then fourth one, the market was buzzing like a beehive. Fifth one, parents' love for their children is as deep as the ocean. ഒരു പോയിന്റ്സ് മിസ് ആയിട്ടില്ലല്ലോ. നോ. ഓക്കേ. നൗ സ്പീക്കിംഗ്. നെക്സ്റ്റ് ആക്ടിവിറ്റി, വർക്ക് വിത്ത് യുവർ പാർട്ണർ. ഇമാജിൻ ദാറ്റ് ബോത്ത് ഓഫ് യു വേർ ഇൻ ദ ഹൗസ് വിത്ത് ദ ഓദർ വെൻ ദ റൂഫ് ബ്ലൂ ഓഫ്. യു ഹെൽപ് ഹിം ടു റെസ്ക്യൂ ഹിസ് ബുക്സ്. യൂസ് ദ ഫ്രേസസ് ബിലോ ടു ഗിവ് ഇൻസ്ട്രക്ഷൻസ് ടു ഈച്ച് അദർ. Here you can see some instructions. Did you understand the question? Imagine that you are in the house of this author and you are helping the author to rescue his books, save his books. Use the phrases below to give instructions to each other. Work with your partner means here you can write it in a conversation mode. First, pick up, be careful, you need to. After that, I think we should. This may be the best place to. You can add these words in your conversation. Is the question is clear? Then Then, are you ready to do it as a homework?
വിശദം എങ്ങനെ ചെയ്യണ്ടേ?
കോൺവെർസേഷൻ പോലെ ചെയ്താൽ മതി, ഇൻസ്ട്രക്ഷൻ കൊടുക്കുന്ന രീതിയിൽ.
ഓക്കേ മിസ്,
ട്രൈ ചെയ്ത് നോക്ക്, കിട്ടിയിട്ടില്ലെങ്കിൽ ഞാൻ പറഞ്ഞുതരാം. റെസ്ക്യൂ ആക്ടിവിറ്റി അല്ലേ, ഇപ്പൊ അവർ തമ്മില് രണ്ടുപേര് തമ്മിൽ നടത്താനുള്ള, നിങ്ങളും നിങ്ങളുടെ ഒരു ഫ്രണ്ടും റെസ്ക്യൂ, ഈ ബുക്ക് സേവ് ചെയ്യാൻ വേണ്ടിട്ട് ആ സ്ഥലത്തുണ്ടെന്ന് വിചാരിക്കുക. അപ്പൊ എന്താണ്, ആ ബുക്ക് വേഗം എടുക്കൂ, അത് അങ്ങോട്ട് മാറ്റൂ, അങ്ങനെയൊക്കെ പറയൂലേ നമ്മള്. അങ്ങനെയുള്ള കുറച്ച് ഇൻസ്ട്രക്ഷൻസ് ആണ് ഇവിടെ കൊടുത്തിരിക്കുന്നത്. ഇതാണ് ബെസ്റ്റ് പ്ലേസ്, നമുക്ക് ഇവിടെ വെക്കാം, ദിസ് ഇസ് ദ ബെസ്റ്റ് പ്ലേസ് എന്നൊക്കെ പറഞ്ഞിട്ട് പറയൂലേ. അങ്ങനെ രണ്ടുപേര് തമ്മിലുള്ള ഒരു കോൺവെർസേഷൻ രീതിയിൽ എഴുതാം എന്നാണ് പറയുന്നത്. യൂസ് ദ ഫ്രേസസ് ബിലോ ടു ഗിവ് ഇൻസ്ട്രക്ഷൻസ്. കോൺവെർസേഷൻ ഇവിടെ മെൻഷൻ ചെയ്തിട്ടില്ല, വർക്ക് വിത്ത് യുവർ പാർട്ട്ണർ എന്ന് മാത്രമേ പറഞ്ഞിട്ടുള്ളൂ. ഇമാജിൻ ദാറ്റ് ബോത്ത് ഓഫ് യു വേർ ഇൻ ദ ഹൗസ് വിത്ത് ദ ഓദർ ഇൻ ദ റൂഫ് ടു യു. യെസ്, ഓക്കെ, യു ക്യാൻ റൈറ്റ് ഇറ്റ് ഇൻ എ വേ ദാറ്റ് കമാൻഡിങ് ഫസ്റ്റ് പിക്കപ്പ് ജസ്റ്റ് ഡയലോഗ് ഫോം. There is no need of writing conversation. നിങ്ങൾക്ക് കംഫർട്ടബിൾ ആയിട്ടുള്ള രീതിയിൽ എഴുതാൻ വേണ്ടിട്ട് ഒന്ന് ട്രൈ ചെയ്ത് നോക്കുക. കോൺവെർസേഷനോ അല്ലെങ്കിൽ ഇൻസ്ട്രക്ഷൻ കൊടുക്കുന്ന രീതിയിലോ എന്തെങ്കിലും ആയിട്ടൊന്ന് എഴുതിയിട്ട് ട്രൈ ചെയ്യുക. യു ഷുഡ് ട്രൈ. ഹോംവർക്ക് ഒന്നും ചെയ്യാതിരുന്നാ പിന്നെ ഒരുപാട് ഇംഗ്ലീഷ് ആയതുകൊണ്ട് ഒരുപാട് കാര്യങ്ങൾ എഴുതാൻ വേണ്ടിട്ട് വരുന്നുണ്ട്. അപ്പോൾ അപ് ടു ഡേറ്റ്, യു ഷുഡ് ഡു ഇറ്റ് അപ് ടു ഡേറ്റ്. ഓക്കെ, ഫ്രീ ടൈം കിട്ടുന്നു, ഞാൻ അതുകൊണ്ടാണ് നിങ്ങൾക്ക് 1 week ടൈം തരുന്നത്. 1 week ടൈം തരുന്നില്ലേ നോട്ട് സബ്മിറ്റ് ചെയ്യാനൊക്കെ? നിങ്ങൾ ഫ്രീ ആവുന്ന സമയത്ത് ചെയ്താൽ മതി. ഓക്കെ, പേജ് ഇല്ലെന്നോ? പേജ് നമ്പർ 17
ഗൾഫിലത്, അത് പ്രിന്റ് എടുക്കുമ്പോ കിട്ടിയിട്ടുണ്ട്.
Did you have PDF?
And
okay, you can refer that PDF. Okay, okay, then shall we move to the next one, last activity, that is writing. A newspaper reporter met the author a day after the storm. He or she gathered details from him about the storm. Imagine that you are the newspaper reporter. Write a newspaper report about the night of the storm. You may include these details. What is the activity? Newspaper report. Prepare a newspaper report about the storm. You are a reporter and you met with the author. So you should write a newspaper report about the storm. You may include these points. How the storm began, the damage it did, then things the family did to brave the storm, what had to be done after this storm had passed. You may begin like this. Normally in newspaper reports we can see a heading, isn't it? In newspaper reports there will be a heading, then name of the reporter, place and date, then the detailed description of that news, isn't it? Did you prepare a newspaper report? ഇതുവരെ എപ്പോഴെങ്കിലും ന്യൂസ് പേപ്പർ റിപ്പോർട്ട് എഴുതിയിട്ടുണ്ടോ പ്രീവിയസ് ക്ലാസ്സിൽ?
നോ.
യെസ്,
പണ്ടൊക്കെ
എഴുതിയിട്ടുണ്ട്.
ഓക്കെ, ഓക്കെ, യു ഷുഡ് നോട്ട് റൈറ്റ് ദ ആക്ടിവിറ്റി ഇ സ്പീക്കിംഗ്. ഞാൻ മുന്നേ ഹോംവർക്ക് തന്നിട്ടില്ലേ, അത് ചെയ്യണ്ട, അത് ഞാൻ പറഞ്ഞു തന്നോളാം. നെക്സ്റ്റ് വൺ, യു ഷുഡ് റൈറ്റ് ദിസ് ന്യൂസ് പേപ്പർ റിപ്പോർട്ട്. this newspaper report as a homework.
Miss, the notebook il ezhudano?
Yes.
Miss, idanna achana
next class in munne aichu vannamadi. You can submit it before the next class. Next Friday. Friday ki munne aichu vannamadi. Okay? ഇതിന് മുന്നേ ഹോംവർക്ക് എന്ന് പറഞ്ഞ കാര്യം ചെയ്യണ്ട, അത് ഞാൻ തന്നോളാം. ഓക്കെ, യു ഷുഡ് ട്രൈ ടു റൈറ്റ് എ ന്യൂസ് പേപ്പർ റിപ്പോർട്ട് അബൌട്ട് സ്റ്റോം ദാറ്റ് ഹാഡ് ഹാപ്പൻഡ്. ഈസ് ദ ക്വസ്റ്റ്യൻ ഈസ് ക്ലിയർ ഫോർ യു? ക്വസ്റ്റ്യൻ ക്ലിയർ അല്ലേ? എ ന്യൂസ് പേപ്പർ റിപ്പോർട്ട് മെറ്റ് ദ ഓദർ എ ഡേ ആഫ്റ്റർ ദി സ്റ്റോം. ഈസ് ഇറ്റ് ക്ലിയർ? എ ന്യൂസ് പേപ്പർ റിപ്പോർട്ട് മെറ്റ് ദ ഓദർ. He or she gathered details from him about the storm. Yes, this reporter collected details from the author about the storm. Imagine that you are the newspaper reporter. Now, you should imagine that you are the newspaper reporter. Write a newspaper report about the night of the storm. You may include these details. Yes, you should write a newspaper report about the night. About the stormy night. Okay, then you can include these points: how the storm began, the damage it did, things the family did to brave the storm, what had to be done after the storm had passed. Okay, try to write this homework. ഹോംവർക്കും നോട്ട്സും ആര് സെൻഡ് ചെയ്യാൻ മറക്കരുത്. നെക്സ്റ്റ് ക്ലാസ്സിന് മുന്നേയായിട്ട് സെൻഡ് ചെയ്യണം. കുറച്ച് ആൾക്കാർ ചെയ്തിട്ടില്ലല്ലോ, അവരിന്ന് തന്നെ ചെയ്യണം, ചെയ്യാത്തവര്. ഓക്കെ, ഷാൾ വി വൈൻഡ് അപ്പ്? അപ്പൊ എലക്ഷനിൽ നിൽക്കുന്ന കാൻഡിഡേറ്റ്സിന് എല്ലാവർക്കും ബെസ്റ്റ് വിഷസ്. ഓക്കെ, ശ്രീ വിഷ്ണു, ജസ്റ്റിസ് ജുവാന, ദെൻ എനി അതർ?
പായൽ.
പായൽ. ഓക്കെ, അപ്പൊ എല്ലാവർക്കും ബെസ്റ്റ് വിഷസ്.
താങ്ക് യു.
താങ്ക് യു.
ബൈ ബൈ.